Hi, thanks for joining us today. I'm Lisa Trail, the Director of Communications for Murfreesboro City Schools, and today as my guest I have Sarah Swarta. Sarah is the librarian at Discovery School. Thank you for being here with us.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here.
So we're going to talk about the little library. Now, we're not talking about our big libraries that are in our schools, but a new project that the librarians across the district, as well as Read to Succeed and the Rotary Club, are joining together to put this program on called the Little Library System. So tell us a little bit about the little library, and then we'll go into kind of where this idea came from.
Originally, Little Free Libraries started in the year 2009, and a man named Todd Bowl in Wisconsin built a Little Free Library and put it outside his home, and he built it to look like a schoolhouse in tribute for his mother, who was an educator. And January of 2015, there are now over 25,000 Little Free Libraries that are worldwide. We're excited here in the city of Murfreesboro for this year, every school campus, as well as some of the off-site campuses, to have their very own little free library. And there are existing already here in Murfreesboro about four that individuals here in the city have put up in town, as well as Tennessee Pediatrics has one inside of their offices.
So as you're driving down I think there's several roads. Maple, I think, has one. Main Street, mm-hmm. Tremont. I'm trying to think of some other roads in town. You'll see what looks like a birdhouse, a right. large birdhouse in someone's front yard, sitting usually close to where the mailbox sits. And that is for folks to come through and look in the library, see if they want a book. If they do, take a book. If they have extra books, to leave a book. So it's just a library swap. And if you're an avid reader, it's a great way of finding another resource other than the libraries at school or the Limbaugh Library. So this is not competing with our libraries, right? So how is it different? Why are we having little libraries outside of our schools and big libraries inside?
The library in the school building is open during the school hours, and usually the students and teachers are taking advantage of those resources. But the great thing about a little free library is that it is a way for Murfreesboro City to welcome its community. So not only the students in that school, but any children and adults in the community that would like to visit that little free library can come by. And like you said, the proper etiquette in a little free library is that if you take a book off of the bookshelf inside the library, that you will also leave a book. So it's a fun way for us to share the books that we love reading with our community.
And most of our schools actually sit inside of our community. So as you're walking down Kaysen Lane, you can just kind of walk around the school, and you would have a library book that you could have access to. I know that we're going to have to stock these libraries, so you want it to be kind of a tit for tat, but sometimes we're going to run a little low. It's going to be for adults as well as school children, and appropriate books as well. I mean, the librarians are going to make sure there are appropriate books out there. But where will the initial supply of books come from?
Read to Succeed has volunteered to help us keep our library stocked. And like you said, the community will continue to swap out those books. And the librarians at each site will check on the little free libraries once a week and make sure that the collection is in good shape. And at any time when we need more materials for that little free library, Read to Succeed is going to help out with that.
Okay, so we have a little free library outside of our schools. This is not just for Murfreesboro. This is a nationwide, worldwide thing. So you can actually go to a website, and it's littlefreelibrary.org, is
yes.
that correct? And you can log on and say, where's a little free library in my neighborhood? So if you were going on a vacation or anything like that, that's a good way of finding little free libraries.
Yes.
The website, correct, right?
Yes, littlefreelibrary.org, and we're so lucky that the Rotary Club here in Murfreesboro has paid for every single Little Free Library. We'll have 15 mm-hmm. for each of those to have a charter. So I've explained to my kids at school, all of our children live close to an elementary school somewhere here in Murfreesboro, and they're excited that even if it's not at our building, they can visit any Little Free Library close to their home, or if they're on their way home in the car, So yes, all of those will be online on the map and you can look them up. And we thought it would be fun maybe during breaks like fall break or winter break to take your kids out and go on a scavenger hunt, pull up the map and maybe visit 3 or 4 or 5 libraries in a day. And the great thing is that you don't have to return that book that you take out of the library. So if your child leaves a book, the book that they choose, they get to bring home and keep.
Which is, it's just an awesome thought process, and it keeps growing. So it's nice for us to have it in Murfreesboro City Schools. Now, we're doing it a little different because we are a school district. And, of course, when you have school districts, you have these wonderful students who are artists. And so right now, the librarians are in the middle of not necessarily the design of the little free library, because we already have the design. It does look like a large birdhouse.
Right.
How are we going to make each birdhouse or each little free library look unique? So how are you involving the students in that?
All of the students in every Murfreesboro City school have learned from their librarian about we're having a design competition so that each school will have a unique design chosen for their little free library that child and the librarian and maybe the art teacher will paint together on site before the library is installed. And we're receiving those entries right now. Any student can turn in their design to their school librarian, and Read to Succeed will choose the final winner for each school. And on Friday, September 18th, Read to Succeed will visit each school and announce the winner of each of those designs.
And that Friday is also Reading in the Schools Day, right?
Yes.
So we will have lots of folks inside our buildings with the Read to Succeed program reading to our students. So it's a very appropriate time to announce that.
Yes.
So is there anything else that we need to talk about as far as the little free library? Is there anything that the community can do for you?
I think the biggest thing that the community can do when the little free libraries are installed is just visit them. And I always encourage my girls, we have to make a plan. So when we know we'll be out in town and passing a little free library, I ask them to grab a couple of books that they've enjoyed off of their bookshelves and just keep them in the car so we're always prepared if we want to make a stop. I encourage Murfreesboro to embrace this idea and to have those books ready whenever you're out and about, and it's a great place to stop and pick up a new book to read.
So when do you foresee the little free libraries being at our school sites? What's your goal?
I would say by the beginning of October.
Wow. That's pretty, you're going to have the design chosen by this 18th, and mm-hmm. So maybe we'll give them a few extra weeks, maybe mid-October.
That sounds good.
So we'll let everybody know when the free libraries go up as we go through the process of getting them designed, painted, and in the ground. Mm-hmm. So anyway, thank you for being here today with us and talking about the little free library. Thank you for joining us. And keep in mind, if you would like to know more information about the little free library program, not only with Murfreesboro City Schools, but across the nation, you can go to littlefreelibrary.org. And we want to thank Read to Succeed and the Murfreesboro Rotary Club for allowing this to be for allowing Murfreesboro City Schools to really embrace this project. So thank you for joining us today, and we will see you again in about a month.